Okay, welcome back everybody. So we're going over the just past KVK that just happened yesterday. So today is January 5th, 2020. So this particular KVK, I decided I was going to try some Garrison Trap. And I used my alt, like one of the smaller alts that I have. It's easy to attack for anybody. It was only about 6-7 million might, I believe. And I garrisoned it with a T4 account. And I also tried it with a couple other guildmates as well. So with this particular account right now, what I'm doing is I'm just bothering the heck out of everybody, just tile hitting them. And you'll notice that I only have about 30,000 troops out or whatever out, but I'll scout them. And if usually people who puts out T1s and whatnot, and I'll try to hit them, but most likely, and if they do decide to come over and hit me, I mean, that's what I'm trying to get out of them at this point. So we're going to have an instance where I was doing this for a while, and then finally somebody, T3 account, about 80 million guy, decides to hit me. And I'm watching it from the screen of my T4 account. And basically he ran into my not leaderless, but I do have heroes in there with a couple of familiars. And T4 is in there, and that's what happened with that particular hit. So here you can see me telling my guildmates that this guy's on Fury and he's only about 70 something million. And I tried to quickly get a rally going, because no matter how you set it up, you send 2 million troops of T4s, this guy's gonna burn and probably get zero on the first hit. So that's what I was trying to do, but it looked like it was at the very beginning of the KVK, and a lot of the guildmates were in different kingdom in Fury or whatever may be the case, so we can actually get that going. But in any case, if you can have a trap a guy, or maybe even take a leader, then you could potentially set your guild up for a rally against the guy who originally attacked the trap. So that's one way to get some points out of there. And you can see here, just with one hit, you're able to get to second stage pretty easy. And I think it actually took me about three hits, and that pretty much finished my solo. And just because I got so many different accounts that I had to jump onto other accounts and whatnot, but I was able to get some points off of a lot of my few of my castles through this particular way. So usually how we'll set up a garrison trap is, what we're going to do is we basically take a small castle and put anti on, and for all, it has to stay at one place, and then for all of his troops, I'll usually put it on ghost rally against the darkness or whatever, minus maybe 10,000 or 20,000 T2s. Or whatever it may be the case. And then I will garrison with my T4 account, and I'll have anti-scout on to the small account. And once I do the garrison, I will port away. I don't want to stay near my small account, because then it may actually trigger somebody to think that it is garrisoned. So yeah, you want to port away and do your thing with your main, and then let your small castle just do its thing by bothering people, scouting. Like this instance here, I'm just scouting everybody, but I don't go scouting like billion might players. I'm scouting like 100 million players and other smaller players, potentially like T3 players as well. And I'll sit there and do that all day, and I'll attack some empty castles as well, just to burn them and to know that make people think that it's a small castle that's attacking another small, just trying to complete solo on its KVK as well. And it's the first time I actually did this, because usually I will do, we'll do forts or whatever, but it's the first time I actually used it through another castle for a garrison, because I'll usually go do solo attacks or we'll do rallies and such, but it's interesting. I mean, it worked out very well, and then it actually worked out for a couple of other guildmates as well. So I don't know, we may be using this particular one in the future. It does get it done quickly, seems like, because people love attacking these under 10 million might active castles. So if you find a small castle that's under that, you know, you may want to see what's going on. You may want to suspect a garrison, especially if it's got anti and it's acting really brave, just going out there and just scouting everybody. There's a chance that it's got a garrison. So here you can see the guy scouting me, 138 million. I feel comfortable enough for him to attack me. And of course, I'm not gonna look too confident, so I'm not scouting him back, but I previously scouted a few other ones here. So eventually you just want to sit there. It takes about 3 hits, and that's all it takes for you to finish a solo. Of course, now the points here, you got to realize it goes to the one that garrisoned the castle. So this small castle is not getting any points. The points I'm getting off of for this particular small castle is the ones that I'm attacking, like smaller castles too, and those are about the only points I'm getting, or maybe tile hitting. Now one thing you feel decently confident is that with 30,000-40,000 troops that you may have out of this particular small castle, the good thing is that even when you come back and they tried to hit you, you have garrison protecting you. So now here, this guy is actually hitting me. I'm checking from my main. With when you're garrison from your main, you can actually see in your tower what's coming in. And obviously here I changed my phalanx to counter their troop type. And with the smaller castle, you can just go on about your business, because it doesn't really matter. And then another, because of this guy is obviously in fury, my guildmate ports in and attacks him and burns him here. Yes. And then you can see me recalling my troops back, because I don't really need to attack the other castle or whatever. So I heal my troops back up from my main. So I have less garrison now. I believe I got like 100 something thousand garrison at this point, or maybe 200,000. And you can see that out of 300 something, I only got 190 injured because the great counter. And it did it. Yep, that did clear my solo 3 there. And here you can see another attack coming in. This one I actually didn't have time to react to, and come to find out it was actually one of their big boys that hit me. And what probably happened was, after a couple of garrison hits, that it got posted on World Chat or the Kingdom Chat, and Big Boy decided to come in and probably knock out that garrison. So I got probably about close to 200,000 injured, but still, that's points for me. And of course, because I didn't have my leader, it was that much injured at that point. But you don't want to risk losing your leader over that, because it's really not worth sacrificing your leader for potential more points or being able to handle it better. It just takes some resources, and if you're resource abundant, it's not that bad of a trade to finish it out real quick. So yes, definitely you need to be aware of this situation. Yes. So after, I would recommend after a couple of hits, I would maybe even think about moving your trap account or the small account and moving, refreshing that Garrison and maybe taking it to a different location as well and changing up the name on that small account so to make it seem new, or maybe even move it to a different kingdom. And you know, not just KVK, you can also do this in your kingdom. It's just called simple, basically it's a Garrison trap is all it is. And then here's the report, and report you will get it to the account that you garrison with. So that small account, all it does is, all only thing that's going to show up in that small account is, it's going to say successfully defended by garrison, or you know, defeat, or your garrison has been defeated, but you won't get detailed reports like you're getting on the main. And then because I lost, my troops are coming back, and then I just sped them back so that way we can go ahead and set up a different garrison at that time. So here's another example of garrison trap I did with my guildmate. So she pretty much put in 250k, we already got a hit. We have about 200k left. Actually, I think we got hit from this particular guy that's coming up. He already sent a first hit with T3s, even though he was like 600 million might, just because he saw my might at 10 million and just really didn't think anything of it. And it's because I attacked one of their guildmates' tile, I believe. Yeah, we attacked one of their guildmates' tile. And so we got told on to his bigger brother, I guess. And so he came in, sent the T3, and nothing happened. Now, since she was done with hers and I already hit all my troops, she pulled her garrison, and then he could hit me, but nothing happens to my might here because I'm already you know, in a ghost rally at this point, those 30,000. And I think I got about 100,000 more troops in here, but they're all in shelter, so I'm not exposed to any danger here. And then of course I'm scouting him back and forth, just trying to lose my gold so he doesn't take it. And then this is how I think with her and I think once they started hitting the trap or the garrison trap, I think it took probably 2-3 hits for her to finish. So you know, as long as you can piss people off with these small castles just by scouting them and hitting their tiles, you can get a garrison trap done pretty easily in KVK. Okay, so here's a different type of trap. It's called Nosser's trap. So what I do is I put on my Nosser's or tile, troops on tile with a different account, and what I'll do is I will instantly clear that tile when somebody's attacking and jump into that spot. Like, see what I did with that particular one? I jumped into the attack that was coming in and took out their troops that way. And I tried to actually jump into second and the third, but he was quick enough to return on that second march, so he actually didn't get to lose his second march, because I needed to random out of that second tile I jumped into, but I guess he got the better of me on that one. But yeah, we did eat one of his marches there. Okay, so let's take a look at that Nosser's trap one more time. See right here, you can see red arrows coming in. And both of these, the blue and orange tile, they're both mine, and I actually have it on two different accounts. And what I'm trying to do is, you can see on the left bottom, a third account. So one of my trap can pull two tiles away and the other one can pull one tile away. So here, ideally, the guy was coming in two, which was great. I was expecting just one, but I was just setting up multiple traps. So what I was trying to do is, you see the red arrows coming in, so I can clear, and I have three devices out at this time. And what I'll do is I'll, as he gets closer, because we don't want him to turn around, but because this was multiple occasions, so what I was trying to do was pull away and then be able to relocate right into the spot of where I'm pulling away, then jump to the next spot where the troops are coming in, and then random out of that second spot, having two armies hit me at one time. Here, it wasn't done successfully, and the guy was aware enough to pull back his second one, so which only allowed me to get one. But if you can plan it out quickly, and even with your guildmates, you can say, hey, as soon as I pull, just jump into the spot and make them hit. And ideally, if you're doing just one tile situation, what you want to do is you want to let them get as close as possible before you pull them, so they can't really do a recall on it. Here, they could actually recall, but I did this because it was a multiple tile. But again, in one tile situation, you want to get them not too far away, really close, and then pull in, so they just instantly, you pour it in, they hit you. And of course, you can't pull your own trap and pour it in because your troops are on their way back, right? So you have to actually work with two different accounts, or you have to be right next to that account. So another way you can do this is you can go on to a tile 5 and you see somebody sending into a tile 5. You can just send your troops, hold the officers, and then jump right into this spot and random out. But make sure, one thing you gotta make sure is that they're not shielded. If they are shielded, they're not gonna be able to hit you. It's just gonna return their troops going back as gather failed. But there are so many different type of traps you can go out there and do. And also with this Nosser's trap, of course you don't have to do it just for the KVK. If your kingdom got a bunch of tile hitters, you can teach them a lesson that way. But make sure you have to be not shielded, and they have to be unshielded as well, to in order for that to work. Now here you can see, again, you see me in the second spot. Ideally, I would have ported or randomed out if I had time. So that didn't work out 100%, but it worked out okay. We still got one kill off of it. So I hope that you guys picked up a couple of things on trapping during KVK, and you can always do normal trapping as well, or you could go attack castles. Just a bunch of different ways to earn your points. I just wanted to share what I did this particular KVK, which probably next KVK I will do something different. But I hope you guys enjoyed this video, and we'll see you on the next one. Thanks.